When you use a messenger bot for your business, you need to abide by something called Facebook's 24-hour rule. And basically what this means is that you have 24 hours to send a follow-up message to your bot users for free. So as an example here, let's say that you sell ice cream. You have this chatbot where users can go through, answer a couple questions, and then at the end, get a personalized product recommendation. So from that point where the user answers that last question in the quiz, you have 24 hours to re-engage those users for free. So as an example, maybe the next day you send them a discount to incentivize them to buy that product. But you're probably asking, well, Andrew, what if I want to re-engage a user outside of that 24-hour window? Like, I want to follow up with them in a week or a month. And basically, without getting super technical, you have two options here. You can use sponsored messages or the one-time notification. Sponsored messages let you re-engage pretty much everybody who's interacted with your chatbot, but you have to pay for the privilege to do so, so get ready to plunk down your credit card. On the other hand, the one-time notification is free to send, but it does require an explicit opt-in from the user, so you're not going to reach as broad of an audience. And some of the business use cases for the one-time notification include price drop alerts and back-in-stock notifications. Now, one last note here before we jump into things, there are three steps for you to get started with the one-time notification. Number one, you need to request access for your page, although you just need to do this once the first time when you're setting everything up. Number two, get the user's consent. And number three, send the message. So that being said, I'm going to share my screen now and show you how to get started. All right. So can you guys see my screen okay right now? Everything's working and sharing. I feel like that's something we've all said a little too much during quarantine, you know, working at home. But in all seriousness, here we are on the Facebook business page that we want to use the one-time notification on, the page that our bot is connected to. So step one, requesting access, super simple. We just go to our business page here, go down to settings, and then advanced messaging. And then finally scroll down here to requested features and request access for the one-time notification. Click confirm and we are all set. Step one complete, super simple. Okay, so the second step here for setting up the one-time notification is getting the user's consent, basically getting them to opt in and agree to receive a future message from us. So here we are in Flow Builder. You can see I've built out part of this product recommendation flow that I mentioned earlier for the ice cream shop. And this is just one potential outcome to keep it short and brief. So basically here we're recommending to the user this Superman ice cream. For me personally, much more of a cookies and cream kind of guy, but this also does look pretty delicious. But let's say this is so popular of a product that it's actually sold out. So we're telling that to the user here. We're saying, hey, sorry, currently sold out. But as a business person, that's not a great move to just leave it there, right? And say, hey, sorry, better luck next time. Instead, we want to take this opportunity to ask the user, hey, do you want us to send you an alert, a reminder when this product is available again, when it's back in stock? So to do that, we're going to use the one-time notification. Imagine that. So under the message here, we're going to click add content, choose one-time notification, and then we have two fields to fill out here. The first of which is the topic. This is an internal tag that you'll use for your own organizational purposes to identify what these users have opted in to receive. So you can kind of think of it like that James Bond movie For Your Eyes Only, because the user will not see this. It is just your own personal way to identify and keep track of what users have opted in for. And then the second field here is the message that is user facing, and we'll fill that out here in a second. So let's start with the topic. We'll just keep it super simple. This is totally up to you, but I'll just type in, for example, Superman back in stock. Looks good. And then for the message, this is actually going to be prefaced by something required by Facebook here, which is get notified. So I'm going to keep that in mind when I'm writing the message here. So it's going to say get notified, and I'll say when Superman ice cream is back in stock. Because again, without knowing that the message is prefaced by that get started text, it might seem weird to just type in when, like start the phrase with that. But because it starts with get notified, that's my rationale behind doing it this way. So we have the topic and the message all set up. Great. Now all we need to do to complete this process is connect this notify me button to the confirmation message over here, and we are all set. Now, before we move on to the last step here, we have two important notes for you about getting the user's consent. The first should be pretty obvious, but that is that it's called the one-time notification for a reason. When a user opts in, they're giving you permission to send them one message and nothing else, so be sure to use it wisely. However, keep in mind that, of course, throughout your bot, you can use multiple one-time notifications if needed. And number two, most importantly, don't mislead users. It's kind of like clickbait thumbnails or buying a bag of potato chips and then you open it and it's just half air. If a user is signing up for something like a back in stock notification, send them that, not something like a lead magnet or a coupon, because if you do that, trust me, Facebook will find you. All right, so the third and final step here, of course, is actually sending your message. So to do that, you want to navigate in the Chatfuel dashboard to the re-engage tab here, and then once you're there, you have two options. You can either deliver the message now when you're creating it, or schedule it, of course, for a later date. Now, in this case, I'm just going to choose deliver now for simplicity. And then once you click that, you'll see this interface. And here, there are just a couple things you need to do. The first of which is swapping out this standard messaging tag, which is the default, for, drumroll please, your one-time notification, which is listed here. Now, if you don't see the topic that you created listed here, it could be for a couple reasons. One, no users have actually opted into it yet. Two, you just need to be patient and wait a couple minutes. Or three, you need to refresh your dashboard and then it will populate for you. So now that I have this selected, I'm going to click through here. And then finally, we just need to craft and actually create the message that we want to send. Now, this is super important. If you don't listen to this and pay attention to it, you can cause yourself a lot of headaches and waste a lot of time. So when you're creating your one-time notification message that you want to send, you are limited to sending one card and one set of quick replies. So what does that actually mean? Basically, you are limited to sending either a text element, an image element, or a gallery element, in addition to optionally quick replies. So as an example here, I could send an image and then a set of quick replies below it. Anything else that I would include here below those quick replies would not send. Or if I would try to send two image cards, for example, or an image in a gallery, that would not work. So again, keep in mind, one card plus optionally one set of quick replies if you so choose. So that's how to send your message here. And because we're going along with this ice cream shop theme, now that they send out that back in stock notification, they can safely say that the day is saved because that tub of Superman ice cream is on the way. And in closing, one final pro tip for all of you out there, the permission to send a one-time notification expires 1 year after the user opts in, so you don't want to wait around forever. And I guess that's good life advice too, right? Carpe diem, seize the day. So be sure to try the one-time notification in Flow Builder today to re-engage your customers and keep your business top of mind. Good luck out there and happy botting.